Students, this is class number 6. Let us go for one more simple definition. So simple, empty set, null set, void set. All of them, all these have same meaning. All of them are one and the same. Empty set is same as null set or void set. Void, void, void set. So empty set from the name itself. So definition it is in that name itself, empty set. You all know very well what is empty. Empty part, no water in that. Empty set means no elements in that. Empty andre kali anta artha. So we represent empty set by pi. So pi, look at the set. So does this set contain any element? No. This type of sets are called as empty sets. Empty sets. A set which has no elements. A set which has no element. A set which does not contain any element is called an empty set. Define empty set. A set which has no element. Or a set which does not contain any element is called what? An empty set. One more example, students. So one more example. So I go for writing A set X such that X is both male and female. What is X? X should be both male and female. Can you collect the elements for X? Is there any person who is both male and female? No. But we have neither male nor female. Neither male nor female. What is it called? Some people you know that. I don't know that. Okay. X is both male and female. This does not exist. But X which is neither male not female exists, I think. Right? You ask your biology sir. Okay. X is both male and female, does not exist. So no element for set A. No element for set A. Therefore A should be empty set. A should be empty set. It is pi. We represent empty set by the symbol pi. Pi means empty set, null set, right? One more example. A such that X is, so you can use so many examples. X is both even and odd number. Odd. Even and odd number. Is there a number which is both even and odd? No. No, we don't have such numbers. So we have even numbers, even we have odd numbers. There is no number which is both even and odd. So X is both even and odd number. So A should, B should be empty set. B. So B is equal to empty set. Empty set. So pi. So right. So one more example. If you wish, I'll give you one more example. So C. So right. C. X such that X is a student. A student studying both in first and second PO simultaneously. Is it possible, students? Is there a student who studies both first and second PO at a time? Is it possible? No. So a student can study either first PO or can study in second PO. A student can be either first year student or can be second year student, sir. A same student cannot study both at a time. Is it possible? No. No means what does it mean? Empty second. So C is equal to pi. C is empty set. I hope you understood, students. Now I go for defining what is empty set. Empty set definition. So definition. A set which has no elements. A set which has no elements is called empty set. A set which has no elements. Elements is called empty set. Or a set which does not contain any element. So or are you write in any way. A set which does not contain any element. It's called an empty set. So I hope you understood this. What that empty set is. So right. Now let's go for finite and infinite sets. Let us move on to one more simple definition. Finite and infinite sets. Finite and infinite sets. Finite and infinite sets. Finite sets. From that name itself, a set should have finite number of elements. Finite number of elements means countable numbers. Countable. That means there should be end. For the elements in a set, there should be end. It is called as finite. Definite number of elements. Is called finite set. Infinite set means numbers goes to infinity. If a set is not finite, it must be infinite, right? So now I go for writing examples. Example. So set A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is a finite set. You take set of naturals. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. Dotted lines represents numbers continues till there is no end. It continues, no end. So right. So okay, students. Now let's go for defining. I go for writing definition. Finite and infinite sets. Right. A set. So finite sets. Sorry, definition. A set containing finite number of elements. Finite number of elements inside the bracket R. So definite number of elements. is called finite set. Finite number of elements or definite number of elements is called finite set. Is called finite set. Is called finite set. So tell me, infinite set means a set which is not finite is infinite set. That's all. If it is not a finite set, then it must be infinite, right? So one more definition. A set which is not finite is called infinite set. A set which is not finite is called infinite set. Infinite set. I hope you understood, students. So let us go for one more definition. Equal sets. Equal. Next definition is equal sets. Equal sets. Equal. So you take example. I take example. Set A. So 2, 3, 4. Set B. So 2, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. Set C. Set C. 4, 3, 2. So which two sets? You look at that sets written on the board, students. A sets no neat aagi nodi avedu set a muru sets alli yava sets equal anta nimage anusutte. Is that set A is equal to set B? No, because the elements of set A and elements of set B are completely different. 5 6, I take 6. Okay, is that set A is equal to set B? No, because number of elements of the set A is 3. Number of elements of the set B is 4. Further, so the elements of the set A, some elements of the set B are different from elements of the set A. So what about set A? Is that set A is equal to set C? Yes. I told you, students, order of the set doesn't matter. Order. While listing the elements, so order never matters. You can list the elements in any order. Yavade order will break up elements and you list maadabodu. Right? Order doesn't matter. That means set A is equal to set C. Right? Set A is equal to set C. So but set A is not equal to set B. Is that set B is equal to set C? No. Set B is not equal to set C. Now, you only define what are equal sets. Two sets A and B are said to be equal if they have exactly the same elements. If both the sets have exactly the same elements. Exactly same means idralli en irthavo adralli adu irbeku. Right? Okay. I go for defining that. So two sets A and B or said to be equal, or said to be equal if they have means both of them have, if they have exactly same elements. Set A elements ಏನಿರ್ತವೋ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸೆಟ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅದೇ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಆಗ ಮಾತ್ರ ವಿಸ್ ದ ಸೆಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್.
So write there. So remember the following. Remember the following. Remember the following. Look at this students. A is the set. Number of elements of the set. Count. Number of elements of number of elements of set A is equal to 3. Correct. Number. Count. Count. Eshtu idave anta. So many elements are there in set A? 3. Right. We represent that by, we represent this in short form by NA3. NA means number of elements in set A. NA andre yen artha kodutte heli? Number of elements in set A. Right. So tell me NB. So NB, I think it is 4. 4. So number of distinct elements. Number of elements of set B are 4. Similarly, number of elements in set C, NC is equal to 3. I hope you understood, students. So let us go for one more definition. Now, let us go for solving problems. Right? Solving problems. First question is, pause it. First question is,